Good morning, students. This is the ninth video of the chapter Socialism in Europe and Russian Revolution. And today we are going to discuss an important segment, an important subtopic from this chapter, after February. So far we discussed that what exactly happened in the month of February 1917. And we came to know that in the particular that particular month, Tsar Nicholas was removed from his kingdom. He was forced to abdicate his throne, and finally the country was free from monarchy. That was the biggest achievement of February 1917 revolution. And thereafter we came to understand that the country, Soviet, that was the mixture of armed forces and workers, and all the elected members of Duma, they came together and they formed a new type of government that was termed as provisional government. So, provisional government was now ruling the country, and which different members were there. But what after the February? What exactly happened after the February? What achievements was there after the February? What were the problems the provisional government started facing after the February 1? So we are going to discuss about all these things. Now, after February, we all know that provisional government was already formed in the country. And in the provisional government, there was a representation of Duma as well as the Soviet. That was a group of workers as well as soldiers. But you have to understand, if I am going to read it very minutely, you learn that inside the provisional government, there was a domination of industrialists, administrative officers, as well as armed forces. And as a result, the workers, those who became the part of the government, they were neglected. Because of the domination of industrialists, the middle class and the armed forces, the workers were neglected. So provisional government was there, but in that provisional government, the wards of industrialists and the elite group or upper class group was more dominant, was very suppressive. So that is why you can't tell that it was a complete type of democratic body. So that is why most of the workers then demanded that no, we want more democratic government. We want a new type of government that will become more democratic, more representative in sense. So that was the problem that started after the provisional government was formed. So basically the workers were not happy even they were the part of the provisional government. The reason you know better. Now, thereafter, in the same year, Vladimir Lenin, who was the socialist leader, he came back from the exile. Because when he was in the period of Tsar Nicholas, Tsar Nicholas exiled him when he was in power. Why? Because he clearly told that he should not participate in the war, in the world war. But his views were rejected, and after that the war started, of course, with the admittance of Tsar Nicholas. And as a result, Vladimir Lenin was exiled from the country because he went against the king. But after the king was not there, when the king was not there, because king abdicated his throne, so there was a time for the comeback of Lenin. Vladimir Lenin came back from his exile. And when he came back, he returned from his exile. He came back and he convinced all the Bolshevik members, all the members of the socialist group, to come his side to raise revolution against provisional government, because provisional government was not a democratic government. So socialist government and particularly not socialist government, socialist group under the leadership of Lenin, they came forward. But it was not very easy task to convince all the socialist members, because within the socialist members, many people were in the administrative areas. They were working already in the administrative areas. So it was not a very easy task to convince all the workers. Even in army also, in armed forces also, many socialist people were there. So it was not a very easy task to convince them to to read that Patla Armed Forces and join the socialist movement, join the socialist revolution against the provisional government. So basically you have to understand that provisional government was there, and in order to challenge the provisional government, a new background was, a new type of government, new type of group was getting ready. That was the Vladimir group, Vladimir Lenin group. Now, when the Lenin came, he formed, he gave his April thesis, because it was given in the month of April. After the February, March was there, and April was there. So what was the thesis that he gave was termed as the April thesis. So basically, April thesis was nothing but the demand that was presented, by Vladimir Lenin. So what was there in the demand? In the demand, first demand was that end of war, because the demand came in 1970, and you know that the World War ended in the year 1980. So first World War, that Russia must stop participating in the World War I. That was the first demand. He demanded that immediately we should end the war. Second, land should be transferred to peasants. Land that was there, that was the part of sovereignty that was presented here, it must be transferred to the peasants immediately, without any delay, so that peasants can go with collective farming, so they will go with cooperative farming, because we all know that the very concept of socialism was that we should not concentrate property in few hands, rather it should be distributed to all the groups of the society. So with that objective, the land transformation to peasants was demanded. Now, what was the third objective? Nationalization of banks. Even at that time, many banks were there, were giving loans to the needy person, but they were mainly private hands. So of course, we all know that private bodies will take more and more advantage, they will take more interest. So that is why Gandhi demanded that banks should be nationalized. So if the bank would be nationalized, in that case, the benefits will be given to the public. And here, of course, it is under the people we have to control the government. So these were the three important demands that was formulated by Abdul Aziz. End of the war, land transport to peasants, and nationalization of that. So you have to understand the three important demands were put forward, and after that, many socialist group, many members of the socialist group finally joined the Vladimir Lenin in his movement against provisional government. The provisional government was also very alert at the time, because when Vladimir Lenin has come and he is putting all his effort to topple down the provisional government, the provisional government was very stagnant in that. So he understood the concept of Vladimir Lenin, and Vladimir Lenin was also putting all his effort to gather support from all the socialist group that was present in the country. Initially, socialist group did not support. But later on, some incident took place, and later on he was forced, all the socialist groups were compelled to support the Lenin. And this is how next revolution started, that was termed as the October Revolution. We will discuss about the October Revolution in the upcoming videos. But here we have to understand, now please recall, under the Tsar Nicholas period, 1905 was the first revolution against the Tsar Nicholas. Now here, February Revolution was also there against the Tsar Nicholas, because of that he was removed. And after February, another background was ready for the next revolution. So we have to understand the next revolution was going to complete. So we have to understand this very carefully, that what was going there after that, or under the command of Lenin, Vladimir Lenin. So Vladimir Lenin got the support of all the members of society, and finally he planned to go against the provisional government. At that time, the industrial situation was also changing. Many workers were on the street. They started demanding their rights. They demanded for their basic rights. They demanded to increase in wages. They demanded for more democracy. Because at that time, many workers were suspended. They were punished. As a result, because of that, industrial workers came on the street. The Vladimir Lenin got more support. So basically, he started his revolution with the support of workers. You have to understand that he gave a new name to his party, Communist Party. So Communist Party was now ready under the command of Vladimir Lenin to start the revolution against the provisional government. So finally, the revolution background was develop to defeat the political government. Thank you so much.